So I think, you know, block diagram of two cavity klystron amplifier. So here we are seeing two cavity klystron amplifier diagram. I think you know the operation of klystron amplifier. This is the cathode, okay, and this is the anode and puncher cavity, catcher cavity, okay. Here electrons are released by heating the cathode with the power supply V0, okay. So these electrons travel towards the accelerating anodes, and here electrons are converted in the form of beam, and they travel with a velocity small V0, okay. And after that they are entered into the puncher cavity, okay. So here I already said RF signal is oscillating inside the cavity. So whenever these electrons touches the RF signal positive voltage, then the velocity of the electrons will be increased. And if the electrons touches the gap, at that time RF signal voltage is minimum, then the velocity of the electrons will be decreases and they travel with low velocity. And some electrons interact with the cavity gap at zero potential. At this situation, the velocity of the electrons does not change. So that is nothing but a small V0, okay. So after the cavity, you see fast moving electrons, slow moving electrons, and same velocity like as the previous one, okay. So that's why some bunches will be formed. That is nothing but a velocity modulation. That means one thing you have to remember: after the cavity you see bunches of electrons. So these are called the bunched electron beam, okay. Now you have to calculate the velocity modulation of these bunched electrons, okay. So first you remember capital V0 is the voltage, okay, and small V0 is the velocity of the electrons before the puncher cavity. Got it? Now we will derive the velocity modulation equation, okay. See carefully. So here I am telling velocity modulation process, okay. We know electrons are accelerated by high DC voltage from the cathode terminal, okay. So that high DC voltage is considered as capital V0, okay. And the electrons are moving with a uniform velocity V0 before reaching the cavity, puncher cavity, okay. So I think all of you know velocity of the electron V0 is equal to 2e small V0 divided by small m. M is the mass of the electron, e is the charge of the electron, capital V0 is the applied DC voltage, okay. If you apply the values of mass of the electron and charge of the electron, you get 0.593 into 10 to the power of 6 square root of V0, okay, and the units will be meter per second. So this is the velocity of the electron before the puncher cavity, okay. Are you understood? And already I said you have to apply RF input signal at the puncher cavity, okay. And I am assuming the voltage of the RF signal is considered as Vs is equal to V1 sine omega t. This is the voltage, or this is the signal applied at puncher cavity, okay. And generally the voltage of the RF signal is very 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 less than DC voltage applied at the cathode, okay. Next, now you have to calculate the transit time through the puncher gap. So So what is meant by transit time? Tau. Tau is nothing but a distance traveled by V naught, small d by V naught. Okay, small d by V naught. That is nothing but a T1 minus T0. Okay, so what is meant by T1 and what is meant by T0? So T0 is nothing but the electron enter the buncher cavity. Okay, and T1 is nothing but the time of leaving of the electron from the buncher cavity. Okay, the distance traveled by the electron inside the cavity is considered as small d. Distance is d. Okay, now I am calculating the transit time. That is nothing but how much time electron is spending inside the cavity. That is nothing but a tau. Tau is equal to distance traveled d by what is the velocity of the electron? V naught, small d by V naught. That is nothing but you can write T1 minus T0. Okay, so that's why here represented tau is equal to d by V0. That is nothing but T1 minus T0. Okay, now you have to calculate the average gap transit angle theta z. Average gap transit angle theta z. Okay, so what is meant by theta z? Theta z is nothing but omega tau. Omega tau. Okay, so omega is equal to T1 minus T0. You can write. Now you can write omega d by V naught. Omega d by V naught. Okay, I will show one thing. Actually this is the RF signal applied at the buncher cavity. Okay, buncher cavity, x-axis time, and what is the voltage of the RF signal? We already assumed Vs equal to V1 sin omega t. So maximum voltage is V1 and this is considered as a Vs. So Vs is equal to V1 sin omega t. Okay, and suppose this is the signal traveling through the buncher gap or buncher gap of the cavity small d. Okay, entering the cavity is time is T0 and leaving the cavity time is T1. T0, T1. Now I am converting in the form of radians. That is nothing but a theta z. Gap transit angle theta z equal to omega tau. Omega, that is equal to omega into T1 minus T0. We can write omega d by V0. Okay, now I think you know the cavity is like this. Cavity is like this. And here we are applying RF signal. Here we are applying RF signal, input signal. So the signal will be traveled like this. Okay. Now I want to calculate average voltage present at this gap at any time. Average voltage present at this cavity, that may be minimum voltage, maximum voltage, or zero voltage, whatever may be. What is the average voltage? Okay, so I think you know already how to calculate average voltage of the sinusoidal signal. I think in half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier EDC, you already derived RMS value, root mean square value calculated. Okay, and average value. So for a sinusoidal signal, what is the formula for average? 1 by tau integral T0 to T1 and voltage is V1 sin omega t. So you can write V1 sin omega t dt. So this is the average signal present at the buncher grid. Gap of the buncher gap, buncher cavity. Okay, now solve this equation. Okay, average microwave voltage. Now you have to expand this equation. Okay, now I will show. 1 minute. Now integral of v1 sin omega t. So v1 is the constant one, integral of sin is nothing but a minus cos. Okay, minus cos. So we can write minus v1 constant outside and integral of sin theta t. So we can write minus cos theta t by theta. So omega comes to denominator. So v1 omega tau, okay, cos omega t, and you have to apply the limits t naught to t1. So now what happens? So minus v1 by omega tau is equal to, v1 by omega tau is equal into cos omega t1 minus cos omega t0. I just applied limits. Okay, now we are getting the equation like this, omega t0, and this is the omega t1. Okay, now again I am simplifying this equation like this, v1 by omega tau minus outside minus another inside pump which is now prime out in the then cos omega t naught minus cos omega t1 cos omega t1. So in place of omega t1 we can write, we know omega t1 minus omega t0 is equal to, what is the formula? Theta z is equal to omega d by v0, we already see. Okay, you have to remember. Okay, so from this equation, what is the formula of omega t1? Omega t1 is equal to omega d by v0 plus omega t0. Okay, so now substitute this value here. Then average microwave voltage is equal to v1 by omega tau cos omega t naught minus cos, tell me, cos omega t naught plus omega d by t naught. You can write like this. Okay, in place of omega t1, I am substituting omega d by v0 plus omega t0. Okay, so I am substituting here. Okay, now I am converting this entire equation in the form of cos a minus b minus of cos a plus b. What is the formula? 2 sin a sin b. Okay, so how you convert this equation like this? So you have to take some assumptions. So here, what is the assumption of a? If I take a is equal to omega t naught, please listen carefully, omega t naught omega d by v naught, this is the value I am taking, a is equal to. Okay, and I am taking 2 here, that is the assumption. So omega t naught plus omega d by v naught is nothing but theta z, so theta z by 2, and I am considering b is equal to omega d by 2 v naught, that is equal to theta z by 2 b value. Now see, substitute a minus b, then what happens? A minus b, what happens? A minus b, theta z by 2, theta z by 2 will be cancelled, and omega t naught will remain. okay? What about a plus b? If we add a plus b, omega t naught plus theta g by 2 plus theta g by 2. So here we are getting omega t naught plus theta z. Okay, so omega t naught plus omega d by b naught is nothing but a theta z. Okay, so here we can write a plus b and omega t naught. Omega t naught is nothing but a minus b. So this is in the form of cos a minus b minus of cos a plus b. So what is the formula? Cos a minus b minus of cos a plus b, that is equal to 2 sin a sin b. So now I am converting this equation in the form of sin. Okay, so average microwave signal voltage, that is equal to v1 by omega tau. Okay, we are getting 2 because 2 sin a sin b. What is the formula of sin? Sin, what is the value of a? A is equal to omega t naught plus theta z by 2 into, what is the value of b? Sin a minus b into 2 sin a into sin b. What is the value of b? Theta z by 2. So we can write sin theta z by 2. So I am converting in the form of 2 sin a sin b. Okay, now small change. So omega t by tau, numerator tau is 2 is can come to denominator. Okay, we can write v1 omega. Tau is nothing but what is the formula of tau? We can write in place of tau, we can write d by v naught. Okay, d by v naught, or we can write omega tau is nothing but a theta z. Otherwise we can write directly theta z. Omega tau is nothing but a theta z divided by 2. Numerator to will become to here theta z by 2, v1 by theta z by 2 into sine theta z by 2. You can write here like this, and as sine omega t naught plus theta z by 2. Okay, now assume this term sin theta z by 2 divided by theta z by 2 is nothing but a beta I. Is nothing but a beta I. Beta I is nothing but a beam coupling coefficient. Beam coupling coefficient. Beta I is nothing but a beam coupling coefficient. So we can write beta I is equal to sin theta z by 2 divided by theta z by 2. Okay, now substitute beta value here. Then we get average microwave signal voltage across the gap, catcher, buncher cavity, gap, is nothing but a V1 into beta I sin omega t naught plus theta z by 2. Okay, so that is the average microwave signal voltage present. Average microwave signal voltage present across this gap. Across this gap. So here Vs is nothing but a beta I V1 sin omega t naught plus theta z by 2. Okay, this is the nothing but a Vs. From this Vs voltage, now you have to find the velocity of the electrons after buncher cavity, that is nothing but a V of t1. You have to find the value of v of t1. That will be discussed in next class. Okay, so you have to remember one thing, that is vs is nothing but the average gap voltage present across the puncture cavity. So what is the formula? Vs beta I v1 sine omega t naught plus theta z by 2. So finally we are finding the voltage, average voltage across this gap. Okay, if that voltage is maximum, then electron will travel with the high speed. If vs average voltage is minimum, then electron travel with less velocity. And if Vs is 0, okay, average voltage across this gap is 0, then electron does not change its velocity, it travel with V0, okay. So here velocity modulation is mainly due to RF signal and the electron beam interaction, okay. Thank you.